Thank you. Sportsman 85 to 125. in a moment.
Thank you.
first place finisher, Dan Bromley. Wow, Dan, what a race that was. You found yourself leading that one, and then next thing you know, it was a two-rider battle between you and Corey. You guys went back and forth there, and then next thing you know, it was a three-rider battle. Heck of a main event. How was it from your point of view?
Oh, it was good. I think the track really came in where it was super racy. I had a really good line for most of the day that was going around the top, and Corey just dug deep and he found a better line, and then here came Braden around the bottom, just like around the Huey line, and I'm like, God dang, where are these kids coming from? But we're good. I'm happy to be up here and to celebrate the life of a great rider and great person, and pretty cool to be up here. And one's retired and then one's new pro for next year, so it's cool to have new generation, current generation, and past. So pretty cool.
Yeah, well said from the 62 and our third place finisher, Dan Bromley. Let's put our hands together for the 62 of Dan Bromley, our third place finisher here today. And in second, boy, what a tough comeback that was. I mean, you came back to second. I know that's not what you wanted, but a heck of a ride. What happened over there coming off of turn number four? How'd you end up on the ground?
To be honest, I don't even know. Just got on the throttle and the thing stepped out and it just went back the other way and hit the ground pretty hard. And I'm gonna be sore for the next couple weeks.
I mean, you still gotta be proud of your efforts to come all the way back from the tail end of the field on a racetrack that's fairly hard to pass on, especially with so many fast guys that were in that main event. You did a fantastic job coming through the field and you had a shot at the win, so you know you're a fast guy and that has to feel good.
Yeah. I hit the ground and I'm standing there and I rode around the track. I'm like, they better watch out because here I come. So we got up to behind Dan and they were there. And I was, like Dan said, I was riding the Pee Wee line on the bottom and we were making it work. And I got by him and was kind of pulling Corey in a little bit, but I ran out of time. So we did what we could from the back and I'm proud of my effort, but we're gonna be sore for a while.
Well, I know there's a lot of people here today that are proud of your efforts, including your mom and dad standing alongside. Let's put our hands together for the 88 of Braden Fanders for coming from the back of the field to finish second. A very impressive ride here. And as I said earlier today, every time I've seen this guy ride a motorcycle this year, he's in this spot in the winner's circle, none other than the 65 of Corey Texter. Corey, you didn't get the start you wanted. I counted you fifth that first lap, but man, you were Mr. Smooth on that throttle.
Yeah, this track is so technical. The low line was working, but then I didn't want to commit to it in both corners, and I couldn't really figure out where I wanted to go, and he was high, and I was coming off two really low and it was working good, but I didn't like it so much in turn four, so I was kind of riding a weird line, but it was a fun race. Just trying to baby the throttle, man. It's someone's in front of you and you want to panic and give a gas, and it's all about being smooth, so this is rad. Yeah, I don't really like these slippery tracks, but this was fun. I knew I had to dust off this bike for Ryan. I miss that kid, man. I miss just hanging out with him. I just a lot of time spent with Ryan, and look at this guy, man. It's just such a genuine guy. I miss him so much. It's just a part of me is empty without him in my life. But yeah, this is cool. I had a lot of fun today. It's just cool seeing all my local race people and hanging out with everybody. And our district's in good hands. We have a lot of really fast young kids coming up. And I'll be here to root for him every step of the way. But big shout out to everybody that makes this happen. Daryl Bear for putting the race on. His whole team, the track workers. Everybody that just contributed. Cool to see the Barnes family here. Love every one of them. And yeah, for Ryan.
Well, let's put our hands together for this year's winner, Corey Texter, who's going to be able to take that plaque home, hanging on his wall to bring back next year. And actually, I should ask you, Corey, before I let you go, are you going to be back next year to defend that?
I don't know what else I'd be doing. You know, I just I like going in circles. So yeah, I'll be back, I'm sure, and looking forward to it.
Sounds good. We hope to see all three of these riders back next year. Put your hands together one last time for our top three finishers. also like to take this time to thank each and every one of you in attendance, whether you were here spectating and watching or participating in your respective class for being part of today's racing event. We hope to see you at more District 6 races in the future and back here next year for the Ryan Barnes Celebration of Life race, where we will see who's going to take home the Ryan Barnes plaque for the third time. Will it be the 65 of Corey Texter, or will it be the 88 of Fanders, or